Hi, I'm Greg Hamer at Backblaze, the astonishingly easy cloud storage solution. I'm going to show you how to sync your data from your QNAP NAS to Backblaze B2 cloud storage in just a few minutes. This video covers how to sync your QNAP data. You can also choose to backup your data. To determine which one to use, it's important to understand the difference between backup and sync. This page and the next contrast considerations about backup versus sync, with backup on the left and sync on the right. Feel free to pause the video to review these in detail. And keep in mind, you may use both depending on which might be best for different sets of data that you might have. Summarizing for you, sync functionality synchronizes your files across multiple devices and cloud storage so that each destination has the same current version of the files. This is great for workflows like media production or any situation in which files are being worked on in multiple locations or by multiple people. This page is the second of two that are contrasting the considerations of backup versus sync. And sync might also be the best function to use if you just want an offsite copy of home media files, files that are not changing at all. Backup, however, is better for files that are often changing. This allows you to save multiple past versions of files in case you need to roll back to an earlier version. So we'll be working with the sync feature in this video, but you can find another video covering QNAP's backup feature on our channel. Here is a quick overview of what we will cover. We will start on the Backblaze website, creating an account and an application key. Then, for the final step, we will go to the QTS desktop and open up the Hybrid Backup Sync app in the App Center and complete the job to set up Backblaze B2 as a storage destination there. By the way, if you're watching this on YouTube, you can use the chapters feature to quickly skip to any particular step by using the navigation element below to the right of the video timer. For step one, we need to create a Backblaze B2 account. B2 is the cloud storage destination where you will store your NAS data. B2 is $5 per terabyte per month and no hidden fees, no tiers, and no minimum retention policies. Here we are on the Backblaze website. You can find this link in the text description below the video that says Start Now. We also included a link to our written integration guide with the screenshots. So if you prefer to follow along with that written version, you can go there. Now, we're going to select one of these two red buttons to start now. I'll just select this one on the left. And to create an account, you simply provide your email address, choose a password, and then click that red button to create your account. So let me enter in here a email address and a password, and click sign up for Backblaze B2. And please note, it indicates here the first 10 gigabytes are free. That's for everybody every month. So don't worry, you won't get billed. And there is no credit card required. We provide that 10 gigabyte free for you to run a risk-free proof of concept. And then when you're ready to activate your account, you can enter your billing details later. Now, what's popped up here is giving us an alternate way to go to that written integration guide. So I'm going to skip that and just go take me to my account. And I need to just log back in one more time and enter in my password. And now we're good to go. We're inside of the Backblaze console. So that completes step one. And now we're ready for step two. Continuing in the Backblaze console, we're going to create a bucket and get your application key. And as we go through that, I'll explain to you what each of those are. Okay, so here we are back in the Backblaze console, and this was the page that we were left on after we had logged in. So now we're going to come down here and select where it indicates to create a bucket. And the first thing we're prompted for is a bucket unique name. And I'm going to use a name that I'm hopeful will be unique, but I do want to point out that this name has to be unique, not just within your account, but across all Backblaze accounts. So don't be surprised if you use a common name and it tells you that you need to come up with a unique name. But other than that, we're now ready to create the bucket, and we're going to just accept the defaults on all the other values. So we're going to leave the files as being default private, encryption of disabled, and object lock disabled also. And with that, we're going to come down here to the bottom where the button says to create a bucket, and we will select that. And I have now been successful, hurrah. So that was a unique name. So for here on step two, we've now completed the first half, creating a bucket, and that's just a storage instance that the files from your NAS will get copied into. And now along the left-hand side, there's a heading for account, and we're going to come in here and select specifically app keys. So I'm going to select on app keys, and then I'm going to scroll down, and there's an option toward the bottom to add a new application key. So I'm going to select that. And I'm going to give it a name very similar to what we had named our bucket. By the way, this does not have to be a unique name, only within your account. Other than that, I'm also going to select on this next option down to allow access to only the bucket that we just created. And so I've selected to allow access only to that bucket. And I'm going to leave it with the permissions to read or write to that bucket. And the next option down, I'm also going to select to allow to list all bucket names. And with that, I'm going to leave the default on the last two values. And now I'm ready to go to the button at the bottom and select to create a new key. Now, as I do that, it is now showing me that I've successfully created my key. And it does have an option to copy to the clipboard, but that would only copy the bottom half, the application key. So I want to actually copy all of this data, the entire key pair, key ID and application key. Now, what I'm going to do is write those off into a separate file, because as it indicates here, the application key value at the bottom will only appear once, and in this case. So you always need to make sure you've copied that, because you need to have both values. It's a key pair. So you have to have both the key ID value as well as that application key. So with that, we have now finished step two, and we're done working here inside of the Backblaze console. Okay, now we're ready for step three. Set up a sync job in hybrid backup sync. So now here I am in the QTS desktop, and I'm going to go in to the App Center for hybrid backup sync, HBS3, and I already have the app installed in my environment. So you can see it here. You may not have it installed. So if you don't see it there, you can come here into the App Center and come over here on the left here for the marketplace for the QTS Essentials. And if you select QTS Essentials, you should see HBS Hybrid Backup Sync. And if it's not yet installed, you would select Install. But mine is already installed, so I am just going to proceed by selecting Open. So HBS is now open, and I'm going to take that up to full screen here on my desktop. And the first thing we need to do is go over here on the left where it indicates storage spaces. This is the bottom of the left navigation. And when I select on that, it's showing me what is already configured in my environment. Now, your local NAS will likely look somewhat different than mine, which is normal. But what we need to do now is set up a cloud server. So currently I have none set up. So here in the top left, we have a create button for storage spaces. So I'm going to select on create, and then that opens up a dialog. And what we want to create is a cloud server specifically for Backblaze B2. So I'm going to select the Backblaze B2. And with that, it now says create a storage space, and I need to enter three values. Now, one has already got a value set for me, and I'm going to set that to Backblaze B2 sync. And then the second thing that it is asking for is the application key. So you might recall I had saved the application key off to the side. So let me paste that in. And then the last item I need to put here is my application key. And so I'm going to paste that in as well. And with that, to create a storage space, I'm now done. And I'm going to come here to create, and I'll select on the create button. And HBS just talked to Backblaze and confirmed that the values that we had entered are valid. So with that, we now have created our cloud server storage space for Backblaze B2. Now we're ready to set up a sync job that will sync the data on our local NAS out to the cloud server Backblaze B2, where we have the icon along the left-hand side that has a little circle going around it. That's for sync. And so I will select on there. And now I want to come here for the option to sync now. And I want to set up a one-way sync job. So I'm going to select the item in the middle here for a one-way sync job. So the Create Sync Job dialog opens, and it has four sub-dialogs. So we're on the top level one to select folders, and then after we complete that, we'll go to the second, which is to schedule, the third for rules, and the last, which is for summary. Now the first thing that we're prompted to do is to select the destination storage space, and our destination is going to be the B2 storage. And we had already configured this storage space. So when I selected Backblaze B2, that is what was selected by default. So we're good to go. And in the bottom right-hand corner, I will select the select button. And what bucket would we like to choose? And we had gone out and created our bucket earlier. So from the drop-down here, I'm going to select the bucket we created, QNAP Sync Demo. With that, we then go to the select button in the bottom right again. Now, it's asking us if we'd like to give it a job name, and I'm going to replace one with demo. And then it's asking us what type of action we would like to do, and we're going to select mirror. And then we're going to choose from our local NAS what we would like to copy from. And to do that, under local NAS, we'll come down here to the plus sign. And it will then go and read the drive. Your drive will look different than mine. I'm going to select demo files and then select on here for OK. So I've chosen that as my source, and then add a, on the right hand side under Backblaze B2, it says add a paired folder, and I will click here to add. And it is showing me the bucket that we had created, and so I have now selected that bucket, and I do want to create a directory underneath it, so I'm going to write on here demo directory and then click the plus sign alongside. And now the QNAP just communicated with Backblaze and created that directory underneath that bucket. So with that now selected, I'll come down here and click on OK, and that's bringing us back here. We're still on that first of the four steps on selecting folders, but at this point, I believe we're close to finish. So when we select next at this point, it now brings us up onto the schedule. And you could set this to be scheduled on whatever is appropriate for your requirement. I'm going to come in here and set up a scheduler, and I'm going to then come over here to the plus sign to add a schedule item. And we're given several choices, a one-time, a periodic, daily, weekly, or monthly. And I'm going to choose periodic, and I'm going to ask it to do it at a time not too long from where I am right now. I'm working at an odd hour. And I'm going to ask it to do this with a wait interval of every 10 minutes. So what it's going to do is at a 10-minute interval, it'll go out and check if any files have changed, and it will mirror them over. So with that, I'm now have got my schedule set. I'm going to click on OK, and I can set up 29 more. I can set up 30 different sync rules. So if you have other directories that you would like to have included in this sync job, you can set them up. And then down the bottom, I am going to ask it also to do a sync now. So as soon as I'm finished, it'll do its first sync. So with that, I'm now finished here on schedule. I'm going to click the next button. That brings me to rules. I'm not going to change any of the settings here this time around. So I'll just go straight to the next button in the bottom right. And that brings us up on the summary where we can review all the settings that we've just made. And I'll go to the create button and set that off. And now that is going to start the job because I asked it to do it now, and then thereafter it will run it every 10 minutes. So it's showing me a little progress bar, and we are now finished. It's a small directory. It had very little in it, so it really did not take much time. So now that the sync job was set up and has been finished, I'm going to come over to the Backblaze console again. And we were last here for the application keys. I'm going to go to the very top, and on the left hand side, the topmost option is B2 Cloud Storage, and second option under that is for Browse Files. So I'm going to select Browse Files, and I see my bucket here. And let me just boost the font a little. I see my bucket, QNAP Sync Demo. I'm going to select on that. And then I see the directory that I said to create. So I see my QNAP Sync Demo directory. And there was only one file to be synchronized over. And I see that that was successfully copied. Okay, so with that, congratulations. We have now stepped through how easy it is to set up for your QNAP drive to sync data out to B2 Cloud Storage. And this can give you many benefits. First, it helps ensure that you have a duplicate copy of your data in a separate location. And it also supports workflows where you might need to have a copy of the data in an area that's shareable among multiple different users. So with that, again, thank you very much for your time and good luck with using your QNAP drive in conjunction with B2 Cloud Storage.